This tiny little thing is a Raspberry Pi. It's only worth $250. But what if I told you I can turn this innocent looking thing into a mean hacking machine? You don't believe me? Stick around. Just so you know, I'm using my macOS to do this, but you can also use Windows 10 or Windows 11 or even Linux operating systems without any problem. So let's get to it. So there are two pieces of software that I need. The first one is going to be the Kali operating system. The second one is a software that I'm going to use to burn an ISO or bootable drive. I'm going to power up my Edge in here and I'm going to type in the Lana Etcher. There you go. And I'm going to download this piece of software for my macOS. The second piece of software that I need is the Kali operating system. So I'm going to go into kali.org, get Kali. Once I'm here, I'm going to choose the ARM operating systems. And as you can see here, the first one is the Pi 2, Pi 3, and Pi 4. So I'm going to download this piece of software right here. It's going to take a couple of minutes. In the meantime, what I'm going to do is I'm going to power up my Belana and install it. Put it into my applications. Once it's done, head into my applications. Click on open. Kill this. And it's loading up. All right, so I'm just waiting for it to download. And the other thing that you need is this little tiny thing, a micro SD card. It usually comes with the Raspberry Pi kit if you buy the entire kit for less than $300. I don't have a micro SD port in my computer, but I do have one of these adapters. What I'm going to do is put my micro SD card in the adapter and then put it in my computer so we can burn the disk image. I'm going to go back to my Belana Edge. I'm going to click on flash from file. There you go. Click on downloads, Kali Linux Raspberry, select target, and then I'm going to choose the micro SD that I plugged into my computer. Make sure that you use the actual micro SD card or not something else. Like, for example, your Apple partitions. Okay, select this and flash. Enter, of course, your password. There you go. And let's just wait. All right, so the flash is complete. The next step is to take out the micro SD card, put it in the Raspberry Pi 4, and then load it up. Let me move my camera so you can see what I'm doing. All right, so we got the Raspberry Pi 4 in here, as you can see. Make sure that the HDMI is plugged in on the first HDMI, so HDMI 1 and not HDMI 2. And then the power is also powered up, plugged in here. So now, as you can see, I have a USB port in here for my keyboard and one for my mouse. And I have my little micro SD card in here. So you flip it over and this is where it goes. Voila. Now I'm just going to turn it on and see what happens. I don't know if you notice, but I have my iPhone right here pointing to the monitor, which is connected to the Raspberry 4. So what I'm going to do now is just turn this thing on and it should be already preloaded. So what we're gonna see is the splash screen on the first boot screen. All right, so that's a good sign. We see the rainbow. This is the typical rainbow Raspberry screen, and now there you go. Kali is loading up. Just give it a few minutes. You don't have to install it or anything. It's already pre-populated for you. And that's done. Now we can go into Kali. The username is Kali. The password is going to be Kali also. And then we log in. And there you have it. That was super easy. If you have any questions, any comments, make sure you post them down on the box below, and I'll be happy to answer all of your questions. I hope to see you next time. Stay safe, stay secure.